Today, there are 2 million descendants of French-Canadian immigrants living in New England. These are our stories. Welcome to the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast.
Venez tous, jeunes filles et garçons, je vais vous raconter l'histoire de notre immigration ici aux USA. De grands aventuriers, de pays étrangers.
Bonjour everyone, this is Melody with French-Canadian News. We'll start with an article by Juliana LaRue titled, Meet Canadian film producer Lucy Tremblay in free virtual program. Check out this article to learn more about documentary filmmaker Lucy Tremblay and the work she has done. More on this virtual event later in this segment. Historian Patrick Lacroix has a new post on his blog, Query the Past, titled, Othering the Madawaska and Travel Narratives. Between 1812 and the 1860s, many voyages were made to the Madawaska region to explore the area. When it comes to this region, many stories are framed in a partial perspective, contradictory and disparaging of the people in the region. So to get an inside look into these travel stories that have formed these narratives, check out the post. On the Modern Franco's blog, I have a new post titled, How Mill Girls and Working Mothers Redefined Franco-American Womanhood. During the 19th and 20th centuries, the Industrial Revolution brought many French-Canadian women to New England. In their new urban surroundings, some of these women were able to find work. But male leaders in the Catholic Church, as well as in the French-Canadian and Franco-American community, didn't approve of working women, claiming that it would ruin their womanhood. Find out how these women redefined what it meant to be a Franco-American woman by checking out the post. Moving on to podcasts, Franco-American Pathways has a new episode. Check out Episode 4, Mapping Franco-Lewiston. Join the podcast crew as they travel through Lewiston, Maine, a city rich with Franco-American history and culture. This week, I have a video suggestion. Check out the Franco Foods YouTube channel with your host, Natalie Hirti of the Franco-American Center in Manchester, New Hampshire. This week, Natalie shows us how to make ploys, which are Acadian buckwheat pancakes. Be sure to check out this episode, as well as the other great cooking videos of delicious Franco foods from all around the world. And now, on to events. On September 3rd and 4th, from 1:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time, check out the Labor Day screening of Slattersville with the Museum of Work and Culture. Slattersville is a historical documentary series that focuses on the 200-year-old history of the first industrialized mill village in northern Rhode Island. This will be an in-person event, but it's best to RSVP through the Museum of Work and Culture by email. Admission is free, but seating is limited to 45 people. On September 27th, from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m., check out this free virtual meetup with Canadian film producer Lucy Tremblay. From Juliana LaRue's article that was mentioned earlier in this segment, quote, Lucy chooses to work on her passion about popular science, social problematic, and environmental reflections. This passion is the result of a close collaboration developed through the years with scenarists, directors, filmmakers, and other members of her team. Lucy has received various awards from the Canadian industry as well as numerous pieces during international documentary festivals, end quote. Be sure to RSVP for this event, which is brought to you by the Quebec Delegation Office in Boston and the Franco-American programs of the University of Southern Maine Lewiston Auburn College. We hope you'll turn in next week because we've got an amazing project to share with you. Le Carrefour, The Intersection, is a documentary about a Lewiston native who rediscovers pride in her Franco-American roots after years of abandoning them. Jesse is joined by filmmakers Daniel Quintanilla and Jessamine Irwin. The trailer is out now. We hope that you'll learn more about the film and check out next week's episode. That's all I've got for you this time. Everything I've covered today will be linked in the French Canadian Legacy Podcast's episode description. Merci for listening.
All right, cool. So I would like, if it's possible, to ask some bonus questions. That's cool.
Ready. Right,
so, yeah, generally they don't have anything to do with anything we've talked about. They go to, well, the couple I use for either the preview episode, which is the week before, because we get, essentially what we do is gives us 2 weeks to plug whoever's coming up next. It gives us another week to hype. A lot of times it's people who write a book, so it gives us another week to hype their book. But here it'd be a movie project, so that's kind of fun. And then we also send bonus clips to our Patreon subscribers. So as a thank you for giving us money. So that's pretty cool too. So bonus question number one, let me see, I'm gonna make sure to find it. So looking up, doing some research, Daniel, I saw a project called The Most Unknown, and just watching the trailer absolutely blew my mind. So I am very curious if you could just explain what that project was about, because I found it incredibly fascinating.
For sure. Yeah, it's a Vice Motherboard production directed by my friend Ian Chaney, and I co-edited the film with him. And it's really just about big questions that remain in science that may be unsolvable, unexplainable, but why as scientists, they keep searching for those answers, even as impossible as they may be. Questions like, is there life outside of Earth? You know, these questions that, and by pairing scientists sort of in blind dates, one after the other, meeting, going into a space of something that's different from what they study, they can ask very basic questions because it's not their field. And yet we get an insight into what drives curiosity and why it's worth pursuing big questions. So it was a great film to work on, to edit, because it takes you all around the world, from telescopes to submarines to, you know, caves. And it's a structure to a film that I've never quite seen. One of our advisors on the film was Werner Herzog, and it was a amazing sort of insight into how scientists think and why they pursue these big questions.
Very awesome.
Now our fathers look at us and sigh with despair, to think that everything they love we simply do not share. But the spirit never dies, our culture will survive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive.
Special thanks to Josie Vachon for providing the music. You can find more about her at josievachon.com. This podcast was produced and edited by Mike Campbell. If you have any questions or comments, please email us at fclpodcast@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at fclpodcast for more information about the topics discussed. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe and leave us a review on iTunes or wherever you listen to this episode.